Hi, and thanks for joining me in another program of Painting with Tali, your art collection. Today we're doing, for the holiday season, a beautiful cardinal out there shivering in the snow, because they always stick around in their native state, our state bird, of course, here in Ohio. And as you can see, we have a blank canvas right now, and we are going to use our charcoal stem to kind of give the lesson here. Always divide your canvas in the center, find the center. That way you compose your round circle, which will be your cardinal, as you compose. And it has a little triangle up here for the face and your tail. Basically, it's very simple. Then flow very nicely how you want your branches to come around so that your composition is not too complicated. There you go. It's a good balanced painting lets you breathe. What I mean by that, optically, spaces where the eye can enjoy itself. And of course, you will put in the other geometry about your cardinal. And when you need to erase, use the design kneaded rubber eraser. This is the one I use. And of course, it will do what you want it to do as far as picking up, erasing what you don't need, touching up, also giving final highlights that you need. And let's just take that off. What do we do with this? We throw it away and get another one that's already done. Okay. And as you can see, we already have this one that is already sprayed. Now we sprayed this with the Grombacher Misten workable fixative. It's the only one that does the Tali miracles here. I can't respond to any other one, how it performs, but this one's it's a miracle. So what it does, it sprays it on, keeps it on. I put all my waters and moistures, and it does not come off. The particles do not come off. The thing about it, it's also like a tool for you, okay? Because on our cardinal, from our model of our cardinal, we want this extra dark. So, okay, we already sprayed. Okay, we already sprayed the first spray of our cardinal black mask there. Now, okay, we put it again, it's darker, so it bonds, and it's almost like it becomes a black and white painting if you want to. I mean, on canvas, absolutely fabulous. Okay, now we're making this branch a little darker. We want to make him a little darker here. We want to accent a little more on our pine spines or pine needles, whatever you want to call them. Pine needles, yes. Mm-hmm. We want to get a little bit of more accent on the pine needles. See, now our chiaro oscuro is coming out a little more expressed. And, okay, our cardinal, just a little bit there. And his little feet there. Okay. Okay. And we're going to spray that. And that should be fine. All right, now we're going to be applying color to it. And I have my model here. So basically we're going to just do this by memory because I cannot fit the model anywhere around here. Okay, so time to use Tali Genius time. Okay, where are we? What are we doing? Okay, the background is kind of like bluish and greenish and whatever, like, Yeah. Okay, we're gonna go black backgrounds, kind of bluish and greenish and stuff. We're going to do that with what color is this? Oh, I don't care what color it is. I don't want to explain colors right now. Mm-hmm. You know, I could have finished this painting in a half hour. You expect me to explain colors? I don't want to explain colors. I am not a happy artist. And I love every minute of it. Okay, hold on, hold on, hold on. What is going on? Okay. Do we want that? Does that look okay? We don't know. We do not know. Turquoisey background, yes, with that. I don't know what color. This other maroon color is doing it for me. I don't know why. I'm on automatic pilot here. Okay. And up here, baby, yes. Okay. Let's get that in there. All right. Backgrounds. Okay. Backgrounds. Yeah, I hate backgrounds. Backgrounds. I don't know. Hold on. This thing has to be pressed a little better, a little harder. Okay. Okay. About that background there. Real pretty. Okay, looking like a snow winter scene. Uh-huh. And maybe some blue. I need transparent blues. We'll use this turquoise one here. Not too transparent, but we'll see how it does. Because one thing, okay, glazing, no. Glazing is, no, where are we? I gotta get that blue. Where's that blue? I need that blue. Okay, here. Glazing is when you have, when it's like cellophane put on top of the canvas. Okay, glazing, we're glazing. Painting, it covers right over, you know, like a base, covers all your freckles. You paint it over it, right? That's painting. So glazing and painting, two different things. All right, so I'm glazing here. It has transparency. That's what I wanted. It's excessively too blue. I'm not too crazy about it, okay? Didn't really get what I wanted to get from there. The other colors were doing just fine, but this one suddenly didn't, so I'm putting some more green in it. Okay, something weird is happening here. Because I'm rubbing off spray. It's giving me another effect right there. It went too much, very moist on there for a minute. Okay. Okay. Okay, hold on. That's not what I want. All right. Okay. We're just getting the background filled in any way, shape, or form. Okay, I'm not worried too much about it, honey. Now, round brush. Oh, first coat of paint, and wait a minute. Oh, detail here. Dark bluish details here. Where are we? Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Haven't lost my bird from my linear picture here. Linear picture, that's plastic language, which I'm saying right now. I guess, you know, you'll pick it up. Very, very nice. A little bit of pink there or whatever. Not so bad. Okay, I'm wasting time right now. Maybe it needs more pink around here. Hold on. No, it doesn't. You know, I wet my sponge, it was too watery, and some of the pasty pigment of the spray is coming off. But we're okay. The bird. The color of the bird, scarlet. Somewhat of scarlet. And some kind of, where is that orange? Do I have any of that orange? Is that orange around here? But oh, orange is down here. Hold on. Okay. That orange goes last. But right now we're getting, we're going to glaze the bird in scarlet. That particular scarlet of it. Okay. Okay. The other one, I did a cardinal in Spanish. It's going to be one of the Spanish shows, and it will be on this month also. I think. I never know when things are going to be on. Until I see it on the TV guide, and then when I look in the TV guide and I turn it on, oh, that's the show they did. Oh, you know, I never know what show was going on first, which I never know. I usually don't know what month we're on, what year we're on. My kingdom is not of this world. Mr. Scotty beamed me down to the wrong spot or something. Okay. Okay. Is my canvas shining? I don't know if it's shining. Okay. Okay, that's going to be the first thing on there. Now we're going to do pine needles. Pine needles with a little bit of brown. We have 14 minutes. Pine needles with a little bit of brown. Some dark brown, sweetie. Where is it? Where are the browns? Okay, is that the browns? That's a dark brown. Where is the browns? That's the black. I don't need that white. Oh, here's the dark brown that I need. Okay, this is the raw umber. Okay. And screw it back on. Because you gotta screw these colors back on acrylics because acrylics are dying to dry off on you. Quickly. Okay. Beautiful pine needle brown. Well, we want more type of brown, type of brown. Okay. And we'll make this brown a little more exciting and put some of this fuchsia in it. I don't know what fuchsia it is. Yeah, a little more exciting of a fuchsia brown to the branch. Okay. Uh-huh. Oh, and there's a pine cone right there. The only pine cone that I wanted to put in the picture because I could not have more than one pine cone in this picture for some reason. I just couldn't. I mean, I don't know. It just didn't balance. You know, my automatic pilot composition program in my brain did not allow me to have another pine cone. Okay. I just didn't know why did I want another pine cone. I couldn't find a place for another pine cone. Okay. It's like having another spouse. Okay. Acrylics for me, you know, people ask me, can you do paint and oils? I have no business painting and oils. I'm getting paint right here, and then when I go on here, I'm having a hard time. Oh, because, see, it's on the tip. The paint's on the tip. You already tipped it off by your stroke. So, dip again. That's the thing. I mean, you want to go. It's not a magic marker, you know. That's it. One, two. One, two. You know. And usually I use square brushes. Let me go with a square one. Square ones sometimes work better. Let me go with square. See? More strokes per square than the round one, baby. Yes. Square brushes are our friends. Mm-hmm. We have 11 minutes. Uh-huh. See, my cardinal is drying right there as I will come back to it. Oh, I love that Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. Last night I do this for therapy. I remember when I was a kid in Inglewood, California, and so Thanksgiving time, Christmas time, they would put that Cinderella with Leslie Ann Warren, you know, and she was so cute and so sweet, and her sisters were so mean, and she did such a good job of being Cinderella, and all that beautiful music by Rodgers and Hammerstein and whatever, you know. And so to watch this for me is so therapeutic in the sense that it's just so beautiful, the lyrics. Now, when I was a child, I didn't understand the lyrics that well because, you know, I had to, you know, become an adult and do naughty things. And then understand, you know, under moonlight garden, what it meant. And, you know, and that's the song says, do I love you because you're beautiful, or are you beautiful because I love you, you know, that kind of stuff. Well, anyway, now that I've lived two lifetimes, you totally change. Your romantic position changes in life. First, when you begin life, you believe in it. Then, after you live that second 20 years of life, then you realize that it was an illusion. So musicals give you that illusion. That's what I like about them. They're very therapeutic. Okay. Do I love you because you're beautiful? Oh, and then I go to these places. One place that I really do like very much is Martini's here in Columbus, Ohio. Lovely place. Great pizza at Martini's, to die. Great pizza there. Anyway, for anybody who visits here, that's a great place to go. And a lot of nice people there that I know. So the people who frequent the place, you know, men go out to bars because of a reason. Why do women go out? There's a very good reason why you see a man at a bar, you know. We all know that. Why do you see women? Do we know what we're talking about? Okay, you have to be an adult here to know what we're talking about, boys and girls. Okay. Actually, women are very easy to charm. All you have to have is an imagination. Okay. Well, the truth is women want to make you happy, but they're difficult to put up with. Men are easier to put up with, but they don't want to make anybody happy. And that's the law of nature. Where? I'm wasting time. We only have 7 minutes. We've got to cover that. Bird. Hold on. Not clean. Okay, we'll use the round one here. Okay, how does my model look? Oh, all right. Okay. Too big and fat of a brush right now. Okay. Clean, clean, clean. It was full of, and this one would have worked just fabulous, but, you know, it's full of this green stuff right now. Yes, I'm out of the camera. I'm into the camera. Out of it. I don't know. I don't have a model. No, and I don't want that one. Sorry. Is this bird going to look like poop? Oh. Wow. You know, on TV, I mean, when I look at it on TV, it looks better than what I'm seeing here. I mean, it looks so beautiful on video. I started putting my paintings on videos video back in Venezuela because they, you know, they would come in to interview me. It was really funny because my parents, my family is really funny because they never took me seriously. I mean, here I am screaming with peritonitis, I mean with appendicitis, and they think that I'm just having a fit or something. They never took me serious. That's what I hate about relatives. You know, they come to your house, 20 years later, you have your own home, there's an Oscar, it says your name on it, and they pick it up and say, why does it have your name on it? Oh! So how can you respect them? okay, where are we? Okay. So I just had to respect my parents on automatic pilot and just, you know, eliminate it out of my mind. You know, that's what happens. Relatives, that's the way they are. You can get a stranger to cooperate with you, but not a relative at times. Oh, we got 4 minutes. Okay. Now, yeah, this is shining on me. And, yeah. I need the, that's not it. I opened up the wrong bottle. No, this one. It's this additive stuff that you can use it like spatula. It's an acrylic gel medium. That's what it says on there. But it makes the color look spatula. I don't want to talk. Plus, most people don't even see my show because they want to paint. I think that most people see my show because I'm so unorthodox. Bitching with Tali. Actually, not. So I want to put some snow on these areas. So that's why I'm putting it violet first. Kind of violet. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, here. And here, okay. That's what I want to do. And we got 3 minutes. Okay, I want super white now. I got too much blues going around here, baby. Uh-huh. Oh, some snow here. Okay, let's, okay. Oh my God. God. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. Do this. Does this need? Yes, it does. Okay. Sombras nada más entre tu vida y mi vida. Sombras nada más entre tu amor y mi amor. I get into the habit of translating Spanish songs into English. There's this one that says, quisiera abrir lentamente mis venas, mi sangre toda verterla a tus pies. You know what it says? I'd like to slowly open my veins and drain my blood down to your feet. Man, talk about, you know, somebody in passionate love. Well, my parents would listen to all this stuff and I'm like, what are they talking about? What a stupid song. On Sundays, after working as industrial slaves. You know, they put on their songs and whatever. Hold on, 1 minute. And yes, can we put some fantasy lights back there? Hold on, baby. You know what we also need, sweetie? We need to, oh my God, and I gotta get out of here. We need to darken him up. Yeah, we need to darken that up. It looks so stupid. Wait. Yeah, okay. Now I gotta get the hell out of here. We got 1 minute. We need some kind of fantasy lights. Some better fantasy lights somewhere. I think we might need yellow for it. Baby, hold on. Oh! Just putting it back. It's so, such, it's, okay, fantasy lights. Okay. Do we need fantasy lights around him? Is it morning or something? Is it like maybe forest lights of evening? The snow in the evening, dusky something coming around? Is it? I don't know. Is it? I don't know. I don't have time to make a painting. I mean, a decent painting in a half hour show. Do we? No. Okay. Yes, let's flood him right there with it. Okay. Let's put it. I gotta get out of here. This thing is screaming at me. Hold on. And around here. Oh, is that nice? Is it? I don't know. Now I gotta sign this thing and I don't, and I need a black on it. Okay. T-A-L-I. You see, I needed to sign it in white. Bye. Hi, and thanks for joining me in another program of Painting with Tali, Your Art Collection. Today we're doing that beautiful edifice that's called the Palace of Fine Arts in that gorgeous drop-dead city of San Francisco. This was a certain project that was done at the turn of the century. It had to do with a World's Fair, I believe, and it was absolutely beautiful. So I photographed it and I made a nice little painting here. And I already designed it and penciled it in, and I did the highlights in white with the liquid acrylic paint, and what I'm going to be doing now is glazing the part of it that is that kind of sandstone color. I have a mixture already made. Now what I do is I check that tone on the side of my canvas so I can see how that tonality looks, and that will test, you know, will test it for me. And I'm kind of like happy with it, so I did a little bit of raw umber to mix in that mixture. So this is what we're going to do right now. We're going to wash all of it. Now see, since I already did my my lighter highlights of white, they're going to bleed beautifully right under this glazing that we're doing. So I'm going over all of it. Even though that these columns are at a more rose tone color of it. So I got to generally cover everything that I know the general color of this, that I know it to be, as in my example photograph that I took. I used one of those pocket cameras when I was out there. And as you can see, you just glaze and smudge. Glaze, okay, glaze all of it. Glaze everything, glaze everything, glaze, 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 smudge. This was not done with charcoal. This was done with pencil, and the pencil was fixed with that fixative spray that I use. So it was fixed with the fixative spray. And as you can see, all the whites about it, the highlight whites that make the texture of your sculptures of the building, it comes right out. See how it transparents out beautifully. It transparents out beautifully. Okay. I get a little richer. You know, it's I can't really enjoy doing, I mean, I whack these paintings in a half hour, I mean, but I can't really enjoy them. But so far so good, everything going wonderfully. Maybe a little bit of richness, just a little bit. Let it dry a little bit. Get your sponge. Okay, the sponge is doing it. Doing it, doing it, doing it. It's okay if it smudges over there on a little bit out. But the idea is to do this first about the whole situation. Okay, we don't have much time. And, just a little bit more on here. On here. Well, even though that's going to be another color. Okay. Dab it with 21 minutes. Okay, that's absolutely beautiful. I'm going to be mixing now the other tonality of green. All right, before that tonality of green, there is some reddish bush beforehand. There was some kind of red bush, reddish type of bush. So we want to get that reddish bush situation in, okay? In the optical effect here before going with the deep greens. Because I know that's how it was. It had some, I don't know what bush it was, but it was kind of, the tonality was red to it. So that's what we want right now. See, when you put your little white highlights over your drawing, you get these wonderful textured effects that will come right out. Now, this actually, we're doing some green now. Some green is coming up. We need more intensity green. Intensity, more of an intense green. Because these were some kind of slivers of leaves, these big leaves. They're all going to come out because they're right under your drawing. They're right in there. So they're all just going to come out pretty soon. Okay. Beautiful. And then the final highlights and stuff. And these greens, green here. Super, super green tonality there. super, super green tonality. Now, tiny dibby dabbies are going to come around, you know, little tiny dibby dabbies. Okay. This just gives me the general aspect of bush that is happening, okay? The general aspect of bush. Okay, and then from that general aspect of bush, we need to control it a little bit with some darkness coming around, okay, darkness. The darkness of the bush is coming around, baby. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Okay. See the darkness. We got 11. 11? No, 17. Okay. Okay. See, that's the way it goes. Beautiful. Get a little bit more. All right, this, you know, that, I'm not gonna do anything right there with that right now because I gotta go sky first on that, you know. That we're just gonna do these around here. They have to happen, sweetie. Yes. Okay. And they have to happen really scribbly, fast. Mm-hmm. These go a little bit db. Okay, like that. Okay. And then this. All right. Deepness around here, yes. I gotta always look at my model. You know, those disposable cameras is what I used, and it does a good job of capturing what I need. It's because it has like a wide angle lens about it. But when I develop them, I have to develop a dark photo and a light photo, because on the negative, I see everything I need. Oh, as a professional artist, you know, what you do is when you take your photographs of your subjects, learn to read your negative so you don't have to pay all that money on developing, because developing can get really expensive. So what you do is you take your shots and you ask for development only of your film. Nowadays, you can get a contact sheet with the new machines that are out there. And on the contact sheet, it doesn't cost that much. And you can see everything that's turned out, so you're not going to use photographs that are badly exposed and, you know, are not suitable for any use. Okay. Up there. There's bush up there, yes. There's bush up here. Well, in the photograph, there wasn't any bush there, but I put it on there anyway because I wanted it to be there. Okay. Oh, yeah, that's beautiful. See, that came out really, really nice because I already have my little white dibby dabbies with the drawing, and so now they're coming transparencing out, making that beautiful three-dimensional texture that I wanted. Okay, washing the brush. Needs some of that sandstone for the detail here since I went so fast. All right. Okay. I'm not too very convinced, you know. Not too convinced. Not too convinced. Not really too convinced. I need some deepness, but we only got a half hour, sweetie. Oh. No, I got a half hour. I'm killing myself here. We only have a half hour. Hold on. When things go wrong, just use your sponge. Maybe things will look better. Hmm. Okay. Yeah, you know what they do? Because most of my drawing is under there rescued before my glazing. Okay, so I'm going to be mixing now a new color. All right, And that color is going to be this kind of like a terracotta or something, because I needed that, and it just washed out on my mixture, and I just didn't get it back, you know, when I put the greens back on. So it's on there somehow, and I have to dab off to get it. Okay, and it's coming on here, coming on there. Okay. It's kind of like mixed into, you know, it's a tree that's there mixed into the rest of the foliage or something. But I'm dabbing and kind of getting it to kind of blend. Yeah. Yeah, beautiful. Oh, and there are some beautiful flowers around here. But since, you know, all right. This same color, though, let me see how it should be. Okay, I'm gonna go on here with it. Perfect, it's fine, it's wonderful on these columns. Okay, because these are the only columns about that structure that are another tonality. Okay, so there we go. And we're gonna go with another one. It's kind of a little, this one's a little brighter. A little deeper in tone. Uh-huh. Okay. Well, I was out there in San Francisco. I visited a couple of galleries. And that's what you do. You have to go and visit galleries and see the type of work they do and see if it's similar to what you do and show them what you do. And that's how you play it out with galleries. It's just trial and error. It's the only way you learn. Okay. We got that going beautifully about that, you know, and then we missed out on this one here. There's a lot of, sometimes details you miss out, and that one was supposed to be one of them. Okay. Also, there's a piece of column here. Piece of column there. Okay. And here, it continues down here. That column there. About that. Let me see. What are we going to do now? Okay, we're going to be mixing now. And what we mixed was a blue. And it's incredible. It's this really nice blue from Utrecht. It's a cerulean blue hue. Okay, see? It's a really bright hue. Immediately has to be blended. Immediately. Okay. Looks pretty good. But we immediately have to go back on here, and stroke it. Okay, see, our fountain came out because it's been already there in white beforehand. All right, boys and girls, let's get the edges around here fulfilled, and let's go out. Your limestone's gonna look a little green, but that's okay. It doesn't matter. The thing is not really made out of limestone. It's like made out of plaster. They made these things really quickly. I just can't believe, you know, today we don't do this kind of architecture. And it's just fascinating to see it. Okay. Ah, but you know, it's a little darker in there, so we're gonna use some of our blue to get that deepness in there. Of course, we are going to kind of smudge it out a little bit, and it will give us that, because now when you smudge it, mixes in with your terracotta color there. Okay, fabulous. Now, okay, we're gonna mix some white. All right, see, we have the white already mixed, and this is so we can clean out the smudge, clean out your drawing from, you know, clean it clean. See, you get your blue. Okay, you get your blue. Just clean it out. In fact, you get more white if you want, honey. Just get more white. Clean out. Clean. You just clean the rim, the edge of your piece. Okay? And you smudge it out. Smudge it out. It'll smudge out to the rest of it. So that's what we gotta do. We're just gonna clean these edges, get that crispy color of sky right behind the terracotta or whatever, that's the building. Uh-huh. You know, my life used to be that I just made a painting, put it in a gallery, you know, and forget about the rest of it. No. But due to certain circumstances, I had to come into the TV monitor, and these are the only paintings that I do. I mean, other than this, I'm not a full-time painter. You know, I'm a TV producer, I'm everything else. But my life used to be just that, make a painting and put it in a gallery. And it's coming back to that now. In San Francisco, thanks to certain galleries in San Francisco that I visited, and they were very gracious enough to give me the opportunity of being in their gallery. Okay. We're just trying to get that there. Uh-huh. What do we have? 5 minutes. See, trying to get that blue accent contrast. You know, your photographs don't even look like the real life thing, you know. The skies are all washed out white. You know, it's just not the same thing. But you took I have photographic memory, thank God. You know, because I remember what I saw. How the colors were. That's, you know, sometimes, I mean, in photography, it's difficult. Okay. Unless, you know, you're a professional photographer. I'm not a professional photographer using, you know, all these lenses and filters and stuff, no. You know, I'm not that. Some photographs are better than others, that's all. Okay. Okay, this is looking weird. Hold on a second. Okay, this has to be more lighter in tone. Uh-huh. And over here, a little bit on that too. Okay. A little bit there. Okay, wasting time. All right. Let's blend. And more intensity of blue up there in the sky corner. More intensity of blue, and we'll have our bluer, darker bluer up and lighter bluer down. Okay. Gotta go. Let me see. I have to mix. Now, after we mixed here, some greenery of foliage. It's gonna be around here, this greenery of foliage. Uh-huh. Beautiful greenery of foliage coming around here. Around here, actually, yes. Coming in that little bit of that urn, a little bit, one of the urns there. Okay. All right, little greenery here with some reddish bushy. Little bit of a reddish bushy, yes, baby. A little bit red, a little bit, just a little bit. Just what you do with your brush strokes, you just fluff it. Uh-huh, fluff it. Just little curly cues like that. Okay, make sure that you got your edge on there well. Uh-huh. Today I'm not being, not very much of a comedian today. You know, this is a very demanding painting. Painting, it's very demanding. So I'm really, you know, I'm really painting today. I'm not, if it was a different type of painting, an abstract, or, I mean, not an abstract exactly, but when I'm dealing with architecture, it's very precise, and so I'm very, very serious. Okay. Uh-huh. Little deepness on these. Little deepness, more deepness, more deepness here. Beautiful. Uh-huh. And there's some darkness around here. You know, a photograph is only like 1/4 of what you saw. It's only an idea of what you saw. Most photographs that you record, I don't know, you know, but you only can do so much with the resources you have. Okay, okay. Darkening around here. There was, yes, some light at a base floor here. But what I want to do is get some of this bright yellow. Because there are these leaves that I'm dying to do. All right, it's this light tone of leaves that which are here, which I was dying to do, because they just don't appear. You know, after, I mean, it's a matter of darks and lights, chiaro oscuro. Okay, so those, I wanted those to appear, all right? Okay, and I'm mixing right now. And now tiny db dabbies, these floating have to come up. Okay, so look natural. Okay. And okay. Now we're mixing another color now. Okay, here we go. And the terracotta tone is right here where we want our final details. Our final details of that stone. Okay. And there's some lights coming in from between the bushes that you see the structure. And over here too. See, this is now paint. It's not glazing, it's paint. But we gotta go. We got to go. See, right now, see, that's how you mix it in. See, in a half hour, I can't create a miracle. I'm sorry, I can do only half a miracle. Excuse me. Now I gotta get out. Now I gotta sign this. All right? That's T-A-L-I-99. Darlings, it's always going to be me, you, the canvas, the camera, and all the wonderful people out there in the suburbs. This is Tali signing off. I'm ready for my close-up. Mr. DeMille's. Thanks, Graphic Dimensions, for your donation of today's frame.
I'd like to thank Monks for their professional service and support in our downtown community, located at 47 East Gay Street.
I'd like to thank the people at Utrecht Manufacturing Corporation, professional quality art supplies since 1949.
I'd like to thank Drexel Theaters for their generous support of my program and for their cultural events they offer to our community.
Hi, I'm going to be having an exhibition on my paintings. For those of you interested in attending, call the following number on your screen for an invitation.
Distribuidores de la siguiente fragancia, One Man Show.